चत्सुरु जिना तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्णपुष्टाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पश्चात देशतारिणे वंचकौपातरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभयेव च पतितानां पवनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृन्द। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। So we're hearing about Narada Muni as he searches to find the devotee who's received the greatest mercy from Lord Krishna.
我们已经听到了, Narada Muni 正在寻找 哪位奉献者得到了主 Krishna 最大的仁慈。
So he had gone to Dwarka to meet the Yadavas, the Yadus, particularly. In the Yadu dynasty, there is a great devotee, Uddhava.
Narada 就去了 Dwarka 城，他在那里遇到了 Yadu 族人，尤其是遇到了 Uddhava。
We know Lord Krishna took his birth in the Yadu dynasty.
众所周知，主 Krishna 是在 Yadu 王朝诞生的。
So Lord Krishna was living in Dwarka with all the Yadu dynasty there, and his grandfather Ugrasena was made the king. Lord Krishna made him the king after he killed Kamsa. He put Ugrasena on the throne to be the king.
主 Krishna 在 Dwarka 城和 Yadu 族人生活在一起，他杀死了 Kamsa 之后，就让他的祖父 Ugrasena 王登上了宝座。
So Ugrasena is speaking about his relationship with Lord Krishna.
Ugrasena 王开始讲述他和 Krishna 之间的关系。
And he says, Lord Ugrasena says, I get pleasure in only one real honor, which is able to carry out Krishna's orders. He said, my greatest pleasure is being able to carry out the orders of Lord Krishna.
Ugrasena 王说道，我最大的快乐就源于我能够执行主 Krishna 的命令。
But I get very disturbed when Lord Krishna honors me. He shows me honor and he thinks of me as being his superior.
但是当主 Krishna 开始荣耀我，并且把我视作长辈来对待时，这让我内心非常不安。
He said, Lord Krishna always gives me so much respect that it gives me pain and it makes me feel like I'm being cheated.
主 Krishna 给了我这么多的尊敬，这使我内心很痛苦，我感觉自己受到欺骗了。
The only happiness of Ugrasena was in taking orders from Krishna.
Ugrasena 王的唯一的快乐就是能够执行 Krishna 的命令。
But Krishna would approach Ugrasena like he was below the position of Ugrasena. He was under Krishna and he would praise Ugrasena.
但是 Krishna 对待 Ugrasena 王的态度就是好像是他自己是一个 在 Ugrasena 王比他的地位要低，在他之下的这样的一个人物，而且他还赞美 Ugrasena。
Lord Krishna would come before Ugrasena and say to him, "You are the noble king of the Yadus."
主 Krishna 来到 Ugrasena 王面前，对他这样赞美道：“你是亚杜族人的高贵的国王。”
You are our grandfather, and you are the pride of the Aryan race.
您是我们的祖父，您是雅利安族的骄傲。
And then Krishna would say to him that you're sitting on your lion throne, so please tell us what service we can do, what service we should do for you.
主 Krishna 继续对 Ugrasena 王说道：“您坐在有狮子标记的王座上，请您告诉我们。”我们可以为您做什么服务？
And when Ugrasena would receive that kind of respect from Lord Krishna, then Ugrasena said he felt very embarrassed.
Ugrasena 王说，当他从 Krishna 那里得到这种尊敬的时候，他觉得非常的尴尬。
So it's also described.That when Krishna entered Dwarka after he was anointed, Lord Krishna had gone to Hastinapur and they had anointed Krishna as the king of kings. So then he came back to Dwarka after that ceremony.
主 Krishna 之前去了 Hastinapur, 在那里他被指定为是王中之王。
And Krishna, as Krishna's chariot came to Dwarka, so he got down from his chariot at the gates of the city.
主 Krishna 的战车来到了 Dwarka 城的城门，他便从他的战车上下来。
And Lord Krishna saw that Ugrasena had stood up.To receive him out of respect for Krishna, Ugrasena had stood up to receive Lord Krishna.
Ugrasena 王看到 Krishna, 他便起身相迎。
So then Krishna says to Ugrasena, Krishna says to Ugrasena, because I officially made you the king of Mathura.It is not proper for you to act in a different way.
主 Krishna 这样对 Ugrasena 王说，由于我已经正式使你成为了 Mathura 的国王，所以您这种行为举止是不恰当的。
Yeah, you should not come and present me with offerings.
您不应该来到我面前给我做出供奉。
You're coming to offer me Argya and Akshman and Padya, all the these different waters. You want to offer them to me, but you're the king.
这些供奉就包括阿迪亚、阿彻玛纳、帕迪亚各式各样的水，但是您才是国王啊。
So these things are actually meant for you. You're the supreme. I'm not the supreme.
这些贡品理应献给您，因为您是至尊的国王，我不是国王。
So Lord Krishna said to Ugrasena, "This is the wish of my heart."
主 Krishna 对 Ugrasena 王说，这是我由衷的愿望。
So when Krishna speaks things like this to Ugrasena, it's very painful to Ugrasena.
听了 Krishna 这番话， Ugrasena 王内心感到非常痛楚。
And he considers these words to be something it is like deceptive. He knows it's not true.
Ugrasena 认为这一席话呢，是不是真的，是带着欺骗性的。
To Ugrasena, these things simply prove that he is certainly not a fortunate. These different things which happened prove to Ugrasena that he didn't really get the real mercy of Krishna.
在 Ugrasena 王身上发生的这些种种的迹象，就证明了他并不是主 Krishna 仁慈的幸运的接受者。
If I had really got the mercy of Krishna, then Krishna wouldn't deal with me like this.
如果真的得到了主 Krishna 仁慈，他就不会这样对待我。
Ugrasena says, no other devotee of Krishna is ever cheated like this.
Ugrasena 王继续说道，没有哪位奉献者曾经这样受到这种欺骗。
But in the case of Uddhava, he enjoys the greatest happiness.
然而对于 Uddhava 而言， Uddhava 享受到了最大的快乐幸福。
He is so fortunate, he always stays by the Krishna side.
他幸运之极，以至于能够恒常地留在 Krishna 身旁。
He's never without Krishna's association.
他从来没有被剥夺了与 Krishna 联谊的机会。
So Ugrasena says to Narada Muni, he says, you please go to Uddhava quickly.
Ugrasena 就继续对 Narada 说，所以请你迅速地去找 Uddhava。
And I want you to give this message to him from us.
我希望你把这条信息替我们捎给 Uddhava。
Tell him that the scheduled time, there was a time today when you were supposed to come to the assembly hall, and it's already passed.
请你告诉 Uddhava， 今天他本来应该来到这个议事大厅，但是这约好的时间呢已经过去了。
So kindly bring Lord Krishna and grace the assembly with the presence of our master, Lord Krishna.
请好心的把 Krishna 也带来，请他能够光临这个议事大厅，因为他是我们的主人。
So,Ugrasena is saying, please allow us to have the master.
Ugrasena 王说，请允许我们能够和我们的主人在一起。
So the point Ugrasena is making is that without seeing Krishna, the Yadavas will be helpless.
Ugrasena 王这番话就暗示着，看不见 Krishna, Yadava们他们是无助的。
They require to see Krishna in person.Every day.
他们需要每一天都亲眼看见 Krishna.
And we also can understand that Narada Muni is more fortunate than the Yadavas.
我们从中还能够理解到 Narada Muni 比 Yadava 们更加幸运。
Narada Muni is more fortunate because he's free. He's free to enter into Krishna's private quarters whenever he wants.
Narada 之所以幸运，是因为只要他愿意的话，就可以自由出入 Krishna 的私人寝室、私人的居所。
So after hearing Narada, after hearing Ugrasena say all this, then Narada, who is a very dear devotee of Lord Vishnu, becomes absorbed in the love of God, and he forgets everything else, and he starts to go to find Uddhava.
听了这一番话之后，全神贯注于神爱的，就 Narada Muni， 就忘记了一切，他立刻动身去找 Uddhava。
So Narada Muni had spent time, he'd been in Dwarka before several times, so he was quite familiar with everywhere in Dwarka. He knew where he was going.
Narada 之前曾经去过 Dwarka 好几次，所以对 Dwarka 非常熟悉。
So he went to the center of the city. He went, there were amazing roads that led to the neighborhood of Lord Krishna's palaces, and he went to the palace of Krishna.
他来到 Dwarka 城的中央，在主 Krishna 的宫殿附近，有一个社区。Narada 就沿着这个大道就来，径直去了 Krishna 的宫殿。
Yeah, he knew how to reach the Krishna's place because he'd been there before.
Narada 知道该怎么去 Krishna 的地方，因为他之前曾经去过。
And Narada Muni is so ecstatic at this time. He's feeling so much spiritual pleasure that he seems like an ordinary person who is possessed by a ghost.
这次 Narada Muni 陷入了灵性的狂喜当中，他看上去就像一个被鬼魂附体的普通人那样。
So now we're going to begin this last chapter of this section. And we're going to hear about how Narada Muni, what he says to Uddhava and the other devotees of Dwarka.
随后呢，我们就来到了，这一部分的最后一章。Narada 他将要，见到 Uddhava 以及别的奉献者了。
Narada is going to inspire them to discuss the situation in Vrindavan.
Narada 将要激励他们讨论有关于 Vrindavan 的事情。
And when Krishna hears about these things, then Krishna becomes bewildered due to his ecstatic love for Vrindavan.
当 Krishna 听了这番讨论之后，他就变得困惑了，因为他陷入了对 Vrindavan 的狂喜之爱。
So Narada Muni had been, before he came to Dwarka, he'd been in Hastinapur with the Pandavas.
Narada Muni 在来到 Dwarka 之前，他 之前去了 Hastinapur 和 Pandava 兄弟在一起。
And he, Narada Muni, he could only think about how wonderful Krishna and Krishna's devotees are.
Narada 一心一的，他当时的全心全意只想着 Krishna 和 Krishna 的奉献者是多么的美妙。
And he picked up his veena, but he was too much, so much disturbed by his ecstatic love, he wasn't able to play the veena.
他拿起了自己的维纳琴，但是由于内心充斥着这份爱，所以他感到心神不安，以至于无法弹奏维纳琴。
And we could question how would he be able to ever find his way to Krishna's palace?
我们可能会纳闷，他是如何能够找到去 Krishna 宫殿的道路呢？
But we should understand he'd gone there many times before. So he took the right road everywhere.
因为 Narada 之前曾经去过许多次，所以他可以找到正确的道路。
Yeah, he didn't even need to pay attention. He just did it automatically. He knew the way.
Narada Muni 他甚至都用不着仔细的去寻找走哪条路，因为他之前曾经去过好多次了。
So the road to the inner city came near the quarters where the king and where the royal family lived.
他沿着多尔卡城的内环，就沿着这个内环的道路接近了通向 Krishna 宫殿的皇宫的这个皇家大道。
And to get there, you had to go through the roads. There were many unusual turns, which made it a road, which is ordinarily impossible for people who were not residents to follow.
这条道路呢，有许多，就是奇奇怪怪的拐角。不是这个宫殿的居民是不可能沿着这条道路走进宫殿的。
But Narada didn't notice what he was doing, and somehow he managed to reach his destination.
Narada 好像是并不知道他在做什么，但是无论如何。他设法到达了目的地。
He was so accustomed to the route, he didn't have to even think about it.
因为他已经熟悉了这条道路，所以他不加思索的便到达了目的地。
But we should also understand that because he was under the control of pure love of Krishna, so he could not actually.Because he has pure love for Krishna, he could actually understand everything perfectly.
由于 Narada 就处在对神的纯粹之爱的控制之下，所以在处在这种神爱控制之下的人，事实上可以完美的知悉一切。
Certainly.Cannot forget the way to reach Krishna. You're not going to Krishna. You're not going to forget that way very easily.
因为他要沿着道路去找 Krishna， 所以他不会轻易的忘记这条道路。
So on the way to the route, sometimes Narada would trip, and sometimes he'd fall down to the ground, and some other times he'd just simply stand still.
在路上，纳达有的时候就跌跌撞撞的，有时候会跌倒在地，有的时候会一动不动的，呆若木鸡的站在那里。
Sometimes his body would tremble, or he would roll on the ground.
有时候他浑身颤抖，有时候他在地上打滚。
And sometimes he would cry in distress.
有时候他在巨大的痛苦当中哭泣着。
Sometimes he would shout, and sometimes he would jump about.
有时候他高叫，有时候他跳到半空中。
And sometimes he would sing and dance.
有时候他手舞足蹈。
And sometimes all the transformations of love of God entered in him at once, all at one time.
还有些时候，对神爱的所有的这些征兆，都同时的展现在他的身体上。
So all of these different ecstasies, they all manifested in the body of Narada Muni.
所有这些狂喜的征兆都在 Narada Muni 的身上展现出来。
Only a devotee who has prema, real, real genuine love for Krishna, can feel the ecstasies that externally manifest in these symptoms.
只有在 prema 这条，在 prema 的境界上精进的奉献者，才可以感受到这份狂喜，以至于展示出这些征兆。
So Maharaj Parikshit is explaining all about this to his mother. Remember, Maharaj, his mother Uttara, she had asked Maharaj Parikshit to tell him what he had learned, because Maharaj Parikshit had heard from Sukadeva Goswami, he'd heard the Srimad Bhagavatam. So his mother Uttara, she wanted to hear from Maharaj Parikshit the essence of what he heard.
由于 Maharaj Parikshit 曾经从 Sukadeva Goswami 口中聆听了圣典不加瓦坛，他的母亲 Uttara 便渴望从 Parikshit 大君口中聆听圣典不加瓦坛的精华。
So he says to his mother, please listen carefully. Listen with concentration to what I'm about to say.
Maharaj Parikshit 对 Uttara 说，请仔细聆听，请全神贯注地来聆听我将要讲述的事情。
Maharaj Parikshit wants his mother to listen carefully because he's going to describe Krishna's pastimes.
Maharaj Parikshit 希望他的母亲仔细聆听，因为他即将讲述至尊主的消时光。
So he wants to attract his mother's mind, and he wants to awaken the ecstatic love in his mother.
他希望能够吸引他母亲的心意，并且唤醒他母亲的狂喜之爱。
Maharaj Parikshit knows by his own experience that there's a certain kind of insanity which comes about due to love for Krishna.
Maharaj Parikshit 从自身的体验当中知道，由于对 Krishna 的狂喜之爱，所以人便会貌似不正常。
But actually, that kind of insanity is actually the most natural condition of the soul.
但事实上，这种神志不健全是灵魂的最自然的状况。
And we should understand that the people or devotees who have this kind of insanity, that they're the most sober, and they actually know what is the reality of life more than anyone else.
而且对于那些貌似神志不健全、不正常的奉献者，他们才是最清醒节制的人。他们比任何人都更加了解真相。
So, Maharaj Parikshit is telling, he's going to describe now. He says, one day, he said, one particular day, Krishna, for some reason, was disturbed in mind.
Parikshit Maharaj 就开始讲述说，有一天，不知何故，主 Krishna 心意感到不安不稳。
And Krishna was, he'd been sleeping in his inner quarters, and Uddhava had left him and gone to sit down nearby, out in a garden at the edge of the palace.
Krishna 在自己的寝室内宫在休息， Uddhava 便离开他，在宫殿附近的一处花园坐了下来。
So while Uddhava was sitting there, Baladev came along, and Devaki and Rohini and queens of Krishna, like Rukmini and Satyabhama.
当 Uddhava 坐了下来，坐下之际， Baladev、Devaki、Rohini 以及像 Rukmini 和 Satyabhama 这样的 Krishna 的皇后们也来了。
Yeah, they all, and there were all, there were other people. There was also maidservants and other ladies, including Kamsa's mother Padmavati.
这其中还包括其他的女仆。其他的女士们，包括康萨的母亲，她的玛瓦提在内。
And Padmavati, we're told about Padmavati that she was a lady who had the habit of making gossip and spreading gossip to everyone.And she would talk about Krishna's personal affairs.
康萨的母亲 Padmavati, 她习惯于公开的对于 Krishna 的私事呢讲闲言碎语。
So,Now, you'll be wondering, naturally, we wonder, how would Lord Krishna feel disturbed? So we're going to hear about that in a little while.
我们自然会纳闷，这 Krishna 怎么会心神不安呢？过一会儿就要揭示这个原因。
So, Padmavati was the wife of Ugrasena.
Padmavati 是 Ugrasena 王的妻子。
And after their marriage, she stayed a short time in the house of her father, who was King Satyaketu.
婚后，她在她父亲的房子，停留了一段短时间，停留了一段时间。她的父亲的名字叫 Satyaketu 王。
So at that time.There was a demon who was a messenger of Kuvera. His name was Drumila. And he became attracted to Padmavati.
就在那段时期, Kuvera 有一位名叫 Drumila 的恶魔的信差, 他深深受到 Padmavati 吸引。
And this demon disguised himself to look like Ugrasena. And when he disguised himself as Ugrasena, he came to Padmavati and he seduced her.
这位恶魔就把自己乔装，乔装打扮成了 Ugrasena 王的样子，来找 Padmavati， 诱奸了 Padmavati。
And this way, Padmavati gave birth to a child. Due to the illicit connection, she gave birth to the child who was Kamsa.
由于这段非法的关系 ，Padmavati。便怀上了康萨。
So all of these different people, they all came to be with Uddhava, and they all sat there silently. They were all in shock.
刚才提到的所有那些人都，和Uddhava在一起，他们都默默地坐在那里。处在震惊当中。
They were in shock because they saw that Krishna was acting strange. Krishna had come, but he was acting strange. Or Narada had arrived. They saw that Narada had arrived and that he was acting strange. Not Krishna, it was Narada. So they were all in a state of shock. And Narada Muni came there. And when they saw that Narada had come there,They saw that Narada was acting in a strange way because Narada was in ecstasy, right? So he was acting strange.
这些人之所以感到震惊的理由，是因为他们目瞪口呆地看到 Narada， 行为举止非常古怪。Narada 就举止古怪地来到了这里。
So these devotees, they would regularly take part in Lord Krishna's activities in the palace.
这些奉献者们每天都会参加 Krishna 在皇宫里的日常活动。
And they were disturbed because they knew that Krishna was laying in his bed.And it was much later than the time when he usually gets up.
他们心神不宁，因为已经过了时间了，但是 Krishna 还躺在床上，他没有按照正常的时间起床。
So they could understand that something was seriously wrong.
他们能够心知肚明，一定发生了什么非常严重的事情。
But they didn't know exactly what was wrong.
但是他们无法 十分清楚的、确切的知道到底有哪个地方出错了。
And now Narada Muni's come there, and they have to take care of Narada Muni.
现在 Narada Muni 来到了皇宫，所以他们都忙着来去迎接招待 Narada Muni。
So they brought Narada Muni carefully to where they had all been sitting. They brought him there.
他们都起身，把 Narada Muni 小心地带到他们坐的地方。
And they took a moment to restore him to a condition, to get, it took a moment to just calm Narada Muni down.To bring him back to normal and to wipe dry his face, which was all wet with tears of love.
他们花了，他们花了片刻的时间，来把 Narada Muni 使 Narada Muni 恢复到正常的状，接近正常的状态，并且擦干了他。脸上的泪水，因为他流淌着神爱的泪水。
So they began to speak to him gently and in a simple manner.
他们开始非常温柔的，以温柔的方式对他说话，但是是一种简单温和的方式。对他开始讲话。
Yeah, they spoke softly, quietly, and they just used a few words. They did not want to wake Krishna.
他们说话都很小声的说话，并且只说了只言片语，因为他们不想把 Krishna 唤醒。
Yeah, they don't want to disturb.Narada Muni any further by saying anything wrong.
他们也生怕说错了话，进一步的就使 Narada Muni 更加激动不安。
Okay, so we'll stop there today, and we'll take any questions.
好，那我们讲到这里，接下来回答问题。
Are there any questions today?
Not yet. 如果大家有问题，那 there is a question. Shruti Rupa, 对所有人说，顶拜 Guru 和老师们，请问 Guru, 年长奉献者指导我们，明天要在高丹山放置母牛和蛇，可是我们都很怕蛇，该以什么样的心态来面对呢？还有应该如何突破对毒蛇和死亡的恐惧呢？ Obeisance to Guru and teachers. So there are senior devotees who guide us that tomorrow is during the Golden Puja, we should put cow and snake on Golden, but we are afraid of the snake.So, in what mood should we face the snake, and to get rid of the fearness to the poisoned snake and death?
Well, I don't know. I never heard before about putting snakes. Some, of course, there are snakes on Govardhan Hill.But I never heard about that we have to decorate our hill with snakes.
我知道高尔丹山上确实有蛇，但是我没有听，从来没听说过要用蛇来装饰高尔丹山。
But if there's snakes there, you can think of them as devotee snakes, right?
但是如果确实有蛇的话，你应该把它想成是有奉爱心的蛇。
And If there's a devotee snake, then we tell it not to bite the devotees.
如果是有奉爱之心的蛇呢，我们就要请求它千万不要去咬奉献者。
Because now you're a devotee and you're on the Govardhan Hill, so it will be all devotees there. And if you bite the devotee, then it's very bad. You get a very sinful reaction.
现在你们已经都成了奉献者了，而且都崇拜高丹山。那么如果这个毒蛇去咬奉献者的话，那么可是一个严重的重罪。
It said Narada Muni has sometimes snakes who become his disciples, and he tells them not to bite the devotees.
Narada 之前曾经有一位门徒就是一条蛇，蟒蛇。Narada 命令这条蛇不要去咬奉献者。
Okay.
第二个问题。有近60岁的 Madaji 提问，在奉献者团队中也有不办理结婚证同居的人获得了灵性启迪，请问这算不算是没有遵守四项基本原则，对孤儒和自己都不好的行为呢？另外，如果心中还对男女感情有愿望，是否无论年纪大小可以再组合家庭呢？There is aMadaji, who is nearly 60 years old, she's asking, in the devotee group, there are also devotees who live devotee couple, they didn't have official marriage certificate, yet they still live together, and even they get initiated.So the question is that whether or not this is not following the four regular principle and not nice behavior to themselves and to their guru.
Well, there are circumstances sometimes where people are not able to get an official marriage.
有这种情况，就是这些夫妻们他们无法举行不能去正式的登记。
Sometimes it does happen that there are couples that are living together and they're not married, but they're living together inKrishna consciousness.
有时候确实有是这种夫妻关系的，但是没有结婚的这个异性，他们居住在同居，但是他们是在 Krishna 知觉当中就是生活在一起。
Legal marriage is sometimes difficult. Sometimes there are restrictions about who's allowed, but there are other kinds of marriages.
有的时候，就是合法的，这种被法律认可的婚姻呢，对他们来说是困难的，并且有诸多的限制，使得他们没办法去，就成为合法的夫妻，所以，就允许有这种情况发生。
So, you can have a marriage couple can go in front of the deities and they can exchange garlands. This is also a marriage.
那么男女双方可以来到神像面前。在神像面前互换花环，之后呢，他们就被认为是举行了婚礼了。
And of course, there's a Vedic fire sacrifice, the Vedic marriage. They can do it. It may not be a legal marriage, but it's a Vedic marriage.
当然，之后他们会举行伟大的火祭。 完成他们的婚礼。这虽然不算是种世俗法律意义上的婚姻，但是这也被算作是伟大的婚姻。
So they should be serious about their vows as husband and wife.
他们应该认认真真地对待他们为成为夫妻而发下的誓言。
And if their spiritual master somehow has agreed to initiate them, then he must consider that they're serious candidates in Krishna consciousness.
如果有他们的灵性导师，同意启迪他们灵性导师应该考虑。他们是否在 Krishna 之觉当中是认认真真的在修习 Krishna 之觉
？OK。
另外，beside that， if somehow， one still have that。affection for the opposite sex in their heart. So no matter how old they are, can they, whether or not they can united with another and to form a new family?
Sorry, I'm not getting your point.
Yeah. So, This Mataji, who is nearly 60 years old, she asked further that if no matter how old one is, if in their heart they still have that desire, can they get married again?
No, it's not good.
那不好，就是不是说无论他们年纪大小，如果心中对男女感情还有愿望，就可以再做，这样不好。
That kind of desire, you should understand that desire in the heart is simply a contamination. And you don't want to pay attention to it. You want to get rid of that.Contamination. And the way to get rid of it is by developing spiritual desires.
你要知道，就是内心的这种对男女感情的愿望啊，是一种污染。你应该小心的去去除这个污染，而反之要发展出灵性的愿望。
The desire will always be in the heart, but.It doesn't mean you have to always try to satisfy all these desires.
这个愿望呢，它会总是会在内心当中，但是并不意味着你就要切实的去满足这些愿望。
Rather, you should understand this is a disease of the heart, and we want to get rid of that disease.
相反，应该能够认识到。这种愿望实际上是一种心结、心病，应该去努力的去除这种内心的病态。
But if you try to satisfy that desire, you'll never satisfy that desire. The nature of material desire is that it's never satisfied.
如果去试图满足这些愿望的话。那是永远无法满足的，因为物质愿望的本质就是他们是永无厌足的。
OK。
第三个还是苏提朱克拉蒂斯的问题，请咕噜训示如何可以把 Krishna 之觉作为生命的中心，除了奉爱，再不受任何外在力量的打扰，为临终一刻只有 Krishna。而时刻做好准备，感恩亲爱的 Guru. So, Shruti Rupama is asking, begging instruction that how can She made Krishna consciousness the center of her life, and except for devotion, do not be disturbed by any other strength, and to get ready for the final moment, the moment to leave the body, to get rid of for that moment, and to keep only Krishna in the heart. Thank you.
Well, you have to fully engage yourself in the service of Krishna. You have to fully take up hearing and chanting.
那你就需要，完全的从事为 Krishna 做服务，去聆听和唱诵。
You have to be just simply fully absorb yourself in chanting and hearing.
让你自己全神贯注于聆听和唱诵。
Okay.
下一个是。下一个是 Yuvati Sachi. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. It's all glory to Srila Prabhupada. Why is Padmavati described as a negative person? It's not her fault that the demon did this to her. 第一个问题是 Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 请接受卑微的顶拜，荣耀归于圣帕帕德。为什么 Padmavati 被描述为一个是负面人物？因为他身上发生的这件事情也不能怪他呀。
No, she's described as a negative person because she's very talkative and she likes to talk about people. And she talks about things which she shouldn't be discussing in public.
他之所以成为一个负面人物是因为他特别的就是健谈，特别的喜欢搬弄是非，他就说了一些不应该在公开场合说的话，说话不恰当。
Okay.
第二个问题 ，Sometimes devotees are very concerned about eating organic food.They do not buy food at the market, but order such products on purpose and spend a lot of time looking for them. Is it correct? 有时候奉献者特别关注只吃有机食物，他们并不在市场上买食物，而是专门订购，并且花很多时间去寻找这些有机食材。这种做法是否恰当？
Well, it's up to every individual to decide for themselves. You know, it's up to everyone to know. Everyone has their own taste, what they want to eat. It's up to them.
吃什么这个是取决于个人。他们可以来决定按照他们自己的口味去吃。
I'm not going to say you shouldn't do this, but it's up to everyone to decide what they want to do.
我们不能说你不能这么去吃，这每个人都有自己的决定。
Okay.
Yogita Radha Devadasi, unfortunately, organic food happens to be very expensive in Hong Kong. In other countries too.
Well, if you have the money, you can spend it.
如果你能支付得起的话，那是可以的，花钱的。
Going to offer it to Krishna, so you're spending your money for Krishna.
因为这些食物最终要供奉给 Krishna, 所以这个钱也是为 Krishna 而花的。
Okay.
Okay, no more questions.
Okay, so maybe we'll stop here today then.
那我们今天就讲到这里。
Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna.
Yeah,
okay, Yogita Radha Madaji 举手了，您是有问题吗？ 给你开一下麦啊。好，您可以开麦。有给他 Radha Mataji。
Shruti Rupa Mataji has another question.
Okay, thank you, Mataji. I couldn't unmute before. That's why I couldn't talk. Sorry. Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna Gurudev, please accept my humble obeisances. Gurudev, I want to ask, I didn't join from the beginning, so I missed that bit probably. But over here, like you said, Uddhava followed precisely everything that the Lord said. Sometimes, Gurudev, even though we know from the scriptures and from the pastimes that this is the correct way, or sometimes the way people behave with us, it's so incorrect. But at times, and we know we are definitely probably supposed to go through such experiences and because of our past bad karmas, but at that moment, the rage and, you know, the anger within us, despite of knowing that it's coming back to us, our bad work before, but at least for a couple of minutes, we're unable to just accept that. And then again, when we remind our mind that, no, this is only paying back for our bad karma, so bear with it. So we are not yet capable of, you know, looking at everything positively, but we are trying to go there. So I just hope, even though we're trying to, that that will be acceptable.
虽然就是我们对经典都很了解，也该知道知道应该采取什么这样正确的行动方式，但是呢，有的时候在我们身上发生那些体验呢，是非常就是让我们很难过的。我们也知道发生在我们身上的这些坏的，令我们不快乐的事情呢，是我们自己的业报、恶报之前的恶报。但是当时呢，就是一种怒火会。冲上来，我们也明明知道该怎么做，但是有几分钟呢，就是会感到非常的生气，我们也知道应该，就是面对自己的直面自己的恶业呀、啊，但是应该接受和面对的，但是就是问题是该怎么以这种正确的视角来看待发生在我们身上的令我们不愉快的这些体验。
I'm sorry, I don't know how to answer your question.
我很抱歉，不知道该怎么回答您的问题。
It's just beyond me to understand what you're talking about.
Okay, good. I'll try saying again. When we just have some very negative, bad experiences where some people outrage at us, are very angry and, you know, very unreasonable. And at that time, we also get angry in the beginning. But then we realize it may be because of our bad karmas that we're having such experiences. But it takes that some time until we realize that or feel that and for ourselves to calm down. And then behave in a proper way in serving the deities at home. So that is what I'm saying, Gurudev. I hope that will be acceptable. At least we're trying.
So what's your question?
So that is what I'm saying, Gurudev. I hope it's going to be acceptable to the deities because that's during, at times it's during the moment of service.
Okay. So I hope it will be acceptable to the deities. Yeah.
这是这有一个那个 Sugi 不是 Sugita 树体 Rup， 嗯 ，Manaji 他代替一个新人问的问题，有学佛的学生问请教 Guru， 佛法里把所有的佛敬奉在最崇高庄严的位置上，为什么进入 Krishna 之觉？一方面强调 Krishna 是佛祖和所有一切存在的源头，另一方面天天都在讲 Krishna， 一天到晚在吃喝打仗，完全没有佛祖的庄严。那么这 Krishna 之觉到底是一个什么样的科学？ There's a Buddhist student asking that the Buddha are placed on a very honorable place, very sublime and sober. Yet, as I came into Krishna consciousness, I found that although Krishna is the source of all incarnation, including Buddha and any other existence, yet on the other hand, we heard that Krishna, from morning till night, is always eating and drinking and fighting and battlefield. Is not as sober as Lord Buddha. So what kind of science is this Krishna consciousness?
Well, you have to understand that those pastimes are not going on every day, but the incidents are recounted. But most of the time, Lord Krishna is enjoying pastimes with his devotees.
您的明白啊，就是这个他的这上述的这些消时光，不是每天都发生的，只是这些曾经发生过的这些事件呢，被记录在案了。其他时间呢 ，Krishna 他在享受和奉献者在一起。
On the other hand, what is Lord Buddha doing? He's just simply sitting, meditating. He's not doing anything.
在另一方面，那佛祖他做是怎么做的呢？他整天是坐在，他只是整天坐在那儿冥想。
So Krishna comes into this world with a mission. His mission is to give pleasure to his devotees. Most of his time is spent giving pleasure to the devotees. Sometimes he does have to remove people who are irreligious, who are opponents, and so the battles take place.
Krishna 进入到这个世界是带着他的使命而来的，他是要给奉献者带来快乐。有的时候为了去除那些非宗教的元素，所以他必须要在战争中去除掉这些非宗教的、反宗教的对手、敌人。
Lord Krishna does also come to us to teach. He spoke the Bhagavad Gita.So he establishes the religious principles.
主 Krishna 来到世上也教导了世人不叫放歌。他来是为了建立宗教原则。
Okay.
Okay. Another question.
Okay, last question.
Okay.这最后一个问题 ，Sugita Sangha 顶拜 Guru 的奉献者，请问 Guru， 我们已经有了 Guru 给的灵性名字，是不是应该在网络上从事灵性活动时用灵性名字呢？She's asking, we have been initiated, whether or not on the internet, while carrying out spiritual activity, we should use our spiritual name.
Well, it's up to every individual. You can decide for yourself if you like to, because sometimes on the internet, you may not want everyone to know who you are. You may want to hide your identity.
这个是个人的事情，这个是因人而异的。有的时候，我们不希望别人知道我们的身份，就是想隐藏自己的身份。
No. So.Some people may have their own individual reasons for not using their name. Then they may also be using their computer for other things, of course, not just only for hearing about Krishna consciousness, sometimes their business activities, their work, they use a computer, so they're cautious about using their spiritual name.
他们除此之外还有别的原因，这个电脑不光是用来听课的，然后他们还在用这电脑做生意呀，工作呀，所以他们用灵性名字不方便。She's asking, so whether or not the Lord Buddha is meditating on Krishna?
Lord Buddha, we have to ask Lord Buddha, what is he meditating on? Does he tell us?
我们需要问一下佛祖冥想，问一下佛祖本人。那而且呢，我们得看一下佛祖他到底有没有告诉揭示给世人，他到底冥想谁。
Generally, in Buddhism, they meditate on nothing. They simply want to make everything empty, void.
通常在佛教里，他们冥想的是虚无，他们想把一切都变成虚无空。
I don't know what the Buddha was meditating on. Of course, there are many Buddhas. Which Buddha? Well, there are different Buddhas.
我不知道佛祖冥想的是谁，而且除此之外有许多的佛。您指的是哪一位？
So, different Buddhas teaching different. It's a complicated question.
所以这个问题它不是，是一个复杂的问题。
Okay, thank you very much, Guru Mani.
Thank you, Maharaj, for a wonderful lecture.
Thank all the devotees for their participation, and I hope you have a nice day. Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai.